Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Professor Mahavir Singh. Today we are going to discuss about the module lattice vibration and thermal properties number 5 from paper solid state physics. So students, let us see what we are going to learn in this module to understand the importance of neutron scattering for the study of phonon interaction in crystal, and have an insight of importance of anharmonicity in crystal interactions, how it play important role, correlate thermal expansion and thermal conduction in context of anharmonic crystal interaction. If the neutron did not exist, it would need to be invented as per Bertram Brockhaus. So just here we can visualize how neutron we need the neutron for various kinds of study of material, structure of material, structure of magnetic materials. So how badly we need this neutron as a source. Most important property of any material are its structure and its dynamics. An ideal characteristic method gives a detailed information about the materials underlying atomic or molecular structure and its interatomic potentials. So, scattering is used to characterize materials in order to determine its underlying structure. So, this is done by using material as a diffraction grating. So, by using diffraction grating, to see the atomic structure, we require a probe of wavelength of the order of length of the scale of interest. So, this is very, very important. If any kind of probe which we used for diffraction grating, this is precondition that size of the wavelength of the source, whether it is X-ray, whether it is electron, whether it is neutron, so wavelength should be comparable with the size of the obstacle, or the if we are using for crystal structure, so wavelength should be the order of interatomic spacing. Then it is important for diffraction kind of experiments. So to see the atomic structure, we require we can use various kinds of probe, whether it is X-ray, which is a part of electromagnetic waves. Then we use also electron as a probe, which is a charged particle, that is scanning electron microscopy or transmission electron microscopy, where electron act as a source. Then neutron is a neutral particle. So that is why neutron is exceptionally unique in comparison with other kinds of source because of this neutrality. And at the same time, neutron has a permanent dipole moment. That is why it is highly useful, because of this existence of permanent magnetic moment, and at the same time it is neutral, it is not affected by any kinds of charged particles. Before going to discuss this neutron scattering, first we want to compare advantages of neutron scattering as well as advantage of electron as a probe by scattering. So basically, electron as a probe by scattering has various advantage. That is, number one, it is good probe for atomic electrons, nuclear proton. At the same time, it is cheap and have easy access, have high flux density, more informative due to small wavelength. So these are advantage of electron as a probe, whether it is SAM, whether it is TEM. Disadvantages also: require very thin sample get damaged post usage, no suitable for determining magnetic structure. So what are the advantage of neutron as a probe? First, it is available in various energy and wavelength as per the requirement of atomic spacing.
low energy probes and hence are non-destructive in nature, have zero charge, thus do not interact with charge matter, have magnetic dipole moment and can be used to study magnetic structure, are good for nuclear interaction and can see lighter element, that is hydrogen, hence favored for study of biomolecules and polymers. So basically neutron as a probe is very interesting as far as this lattice dynamics is concerned or dispersion is concerned, because the matching of interatomic spacing with the wavelength of neutron and energy of lattice vibration also match with the energy of thermal neutron. But there are disadvantages also with neutron probe. First is, it is expensive production, hence not easily available, because the source of neutron is, you know, reactor. So basically its accessibility is a great concern and have weak interaction with matter and require large sample for study. Unlike electron, have low available flux. So basically, if we want to study the neutron scattering, so in idealized scattering experiment, any kind of scattering experiment, a sharp beam of particle of definite momentum K are scattered from a localized target capital B. So particle A is of the beam and particle A localized target is capital B. So if target is crystal, so crystal act as a B. And if our particle is neutron, so capital A act as a neutron. So as a result of collision, it reveals the various possibility. For that is A plus B, when there is collision between scattering between A plus B, so there is various kinds of possibility. Either A plus B is equal to A plus B, so this is elastic collision. If A plus B equal to A plus B star or A plus B plus C, then it is inelastic collision. If A plus B equal to C, then this is absorption. So through scattering or through collision, it may be either elastic in nature, it may be inelastic, or it may be absorption. That depends upon the type of various kinds of conditions. So in order to discuss this neutron scattering, the neutron have a as we know, it has a advantage, that is it has a magnetic moment. So because of the beauty of this particle having magnetic moment, so this probe is very, very important in order to understand structure of magnetic system or structure of any crystal, because of matching of atomic spacing with the wavelength and energy of lattice vibration with the thermal energy of neutron. So scattering of free neutron with matter is used to measure deals with which are of prime importance in material research. Elastic scattering, it is if we consider this elastic scattering neutron diffraction, which is used for determination of structure, whereas inelastic scattering provide valuable information on atomic vibration and excitations. The interaction of phonon is assumed as scattering collision. A neutron sees the crystal lattice by interacting with the nuclei of atoms and exchange energy, which is used to measure detail of atomic and molecular motion by use of inelastic neutron scattering, that is INS. When crystal gets scattered by a phonon gets scattered by a crystal, it results either in absorption or emission of energy of an amount equal to quantum of phonon h nu. The wave vector before and after interaction gives information about the phonon energy. So basically it is interaction of phonon with crystal. Here we study the neutron scattering and phonon dynamics in detail. In elastic scattering of X-ray in crystal, the magnitude of wave vector or frequency remains unchanged, that is omega equal to omega dash. So K plus G is equal to K dash, where K and K dash are wave vectors of incident scattered phonon or photons which obey the selection rule G, which obey the selection rule where capital G is one of the reciprocal lattice vector. Also, the energy and momenta are conserved, that is H omega is equal to H omega dash and HK plus H capital G is equal to HK dash, as the frequency of incident and scattered phonon or photons are unchanged. The crystal as a whole recoil with momenta minus H cross G. This process is called normal process. In elastic scattering of X-ray in crystal, the magnitude of wave vector or frequency remains unchanged, that is omega equal to omega dash. So K plus G is equal to K dash, where K and K dash are wave vectors of incident scattered phonon or photons which obey the selection rule, where capital G is one of the reciprocal lattice vector. Also, the energy and momenta are conserved, that is H omega is equal to H omega dash and HK plus H capital G is equal to HK dash, as the frequency of incident and scattered phonon or photons are unchanged. The crystal as a whole recoil with momenta minus H cross G. This process is called normal process. Inelastic scattering. In case of inelastic scattering, the process leads either emission or absorption of phonon of wave vector K. This phonon will interact with the crystal. So phonon carries no physical momenta or lattice, as phonon coordinates other than K is equal to 0 are linked with relative coordinates of constituent of lattice. But the sake of practical purposes, a phonon is considered to have a momentum, more precisely referred to a crystal momentum. In neutron elastic scattering, the process a neutron interact with crystal by interacting with nuclei of atom. It is used for determination of phonon dispersion relation.
When we discuss phonon-phonon interaction, there is two kinds of medium. One is linear medium. In linear material type medium, the waves propagation follows the principle of superposition and are said to be harmonic in character. But for non-linear medium, the principle of superposition breaks and waves are said to be anharmonic. So basically, this phonon-phonon interaction are of two types. One is a normal process and other is a unclamped process. So basically, in normal process, it is the wave vector, that is K1 plus K2 is equal to K3, which remains conserved. Whereas in the case of unclamped process, it is K1 plus K2 is equal to K3 plus G, where this K1 and K2, whose magnitude is very large, and the resultant K3, whose magnitude is further enhanced, and K3 is greater than. This is very important, that this K3, which is the resultant of K1 and K2, this K3 is very large. It is even greater than plus minus pi by 2a. So it crosses the Brillouin zone barrier, and K3 is negative, and there is a reversal of velocity. So that is why this unclamped process is also important in various kinds of phonon-phonon interaction. In normal process, the direction of energy flows remains the same after collision in normal process, and for N process provide an infinite thermal conductivity in a perfect crystal. This leads us to conclude that presence of other interaction in solid are responsible for finite conductivity. Try to understand this. Generally, when we consider this normal process, through this process, we conclude that the thermal perfect crystal has infinite thermal conductivity, whereas experimental facts say that it has a finite conductivity. That means somewhere there is problem. In one way, we are assuming that it has an infinite conductivity, but practically we are achieving a finite conductivity. So somewhere it need a modification. So that means that modification can be achieved by considering various other kinds of interaction, whether that may be from impurity, whether that may be from grains, whether that may be from the defects in crystal. So there are other kinds of interaction in addition with phonon-phonon interaction that comes into picture as per the conclusion drawn from normal process. This is basically the representation of wave vector in terms of its resultant and reciprocal lattice vector. As in left side in normal process, this k1 plus k2 is equal to k3, so it is perfectly conserved and it is within the Brillouin zone, whereas in M-Klemm process k1 and k2 are not equal to k3, and magnitude wise this k3 crosses the Brillouin zone barrier. That is why there is a reversal of velocity, and this kind of M-Klemm process is sometimes very important in phonon-phonon interaction.
So the selection rule so obeyed is as omega is equal to omega dash plus capital omega, where capital omega is the frequency of emitted phonon, and energy and momentum conservation law becomes H omega is equal to H omega dash plus H cross capital omega, and HK plus H capital G equal to HK dash plus HK H capital K. The conservation of selection rule require that capital K plus capital G equal to small k dash plus minus capital K. It is found that frequency of incident phonon or photon and scattered photon is not same, and the momentum is transferred to the whole crystal. This process is known as M-Klemm process. The kinetic energy of incident neutron is given as h square k square by 2mn, and that of scattered neutron is h square k dash square by 2 capital M by n. Therefore, energy conservation becomes h square k square by 2 capital Mn equal to h square k dash square by 2 capital Mn plus minus h capital omega h cross capital omega, where h cross capital omega is the energy of phonon created plus or absorbed as shown in figure 1. So figure 1 is basically shown where how phonon is linked with absorption or emission. So figure A is linked with the absorption and figure B is linked with emission. So how phonon is created or how phonon is annihilated, it is well represented in figure 1. Now next comes anharmonic interaction in crystal. As we discussed earlier also, when we are considering the harmonic oscillation, there is problem with the crystal lattice expansion or heat capacity. So if we take in real sense, it is not basically oscillations are not in harmonic. There is some kind of anharmonicity which comes into play. That means force, interatomic force, which we consider in lattice is directly proportional to displacement. It is not actually, there is somewhere, anharmonicity, that is higher order of displacement comes into play. So in order to take into consideration the anharmonicity, then we can understand, thermal conductivity, thermal expansion or lattice expansion in clear way if we take into anharmonicity into consideration. So study of lattice dynamics so far deal with the potential energy to a quadratic terms, and higher terms have been neglected up to this stage. The lattice vibration and atomic motions are studied within harmonic approximation. So under which consequences are that lattice wave never interact with the waveform, never changes or decay with time. To deal with the real time phenomena of thermal expansion, thermal conductivity, temperature dependence of elastic constant, the problem of increase in heat capacity at t greater than theta, the anharmonic effects are taken into account. So let for an atom in any position which obey the Hooke's law, the energy expression is given as ER equal to ER 0 plus AR minus R naught whole square. In such case, phonon interaction becomes impossible. One cannot neglect anharmonicity, which is a source of coupling between lattice waves and making scattering of waves possible. Therefore, energy expression has to be the form ER equal to ER 0 plus AR minus R 0 square plus BR minus R 0 cube and so on. So, higher order anharmonic terms make phonon to collide with perfect crystal by making mean free path of finite dimension. So, this is important that how higher order term make our oscillations anharmonic in character. Thermal expansion in solid, which can be clearly understood if we take anharmonicity into consideration. The general answer why solid expand on increasing temperature is that increase in energy results in an increase in equilibrium spacing of atomic bonds. This is fundamental. Thermal expansion is measured by coefficient of linear thermal expansion defined as the increase in length per unit rise in temperature. So, thermal expansion in solid is a direct consequence of harmonicity of the atomic interaction. With the increase in temperature, the amplitude of lattice vibration increases and the equilibrium position shift as the atoms spend time at greater than original spacing due to the repulsion at short distance is greater than the corresponding attraction at farther distances. So, in case of one-dimensional solid, if the vibrations are considered harmonic, potential energy is Vx equal to half kx square or half, and it will be parabola. It will be parabola if it is harmonic, with x0 is the equilibrium position. Then the harmonic potential is a perfectly parabola function and mean position does not shift with the rise in temperature. So, mean displacement comes out to be 0 as given by figure 1. But atomic oscillator differ from perfectly harmonic oscillator and essentially have harmonicity in the potential width comes into play with higher order terms in x. Therefore, for anharmonic potential, as shown in figure also, how anharmonicity comes into play, the potential is given by half fx square, that is half kx square, minus gx cube, minus hx force, and the expression for mean displacement comes out to be, which was 0 in harmonic oscillation, whereas here, if we discuss anharmonicity, which is real time, problem, then it comes out to be 3 small g over fx square kbt, and it comes out to be, as given by equation 2, the above equation suggests a prominent anharmonicity or departure from harmonic behavior and the curve start to deviate. The mean position starts shifting with increasing temperature and corresponding to thermal expansion in physical behavior as demonstrated in figure 2. For small anharmonicity, the first term of numerator takes the form as given by this equation, which comes out to be 1 plus gx cube over hx4 plus hx4 over kbt. Therefore, this expression comes out to be, which is given by equation 3, we find that this appears non-zero, mean displacement in the presence of anharmonicity, which contribute to thermal expansion. Thermal conductivity is the very, very important parameter as linked with this lattice expansion. So, as it is discussed in previous section, how heat energy get transmitted through annihilation and creation of phonon in a crystal. So, this attempt is made to understand heat conductivity and energy transmission in a solid, taking phonon factor into account. For long round, let steady heat flow along its length and temperature gradient is dT by dx. So it is assumed that this energy transmitted across unit area per unit time is called, which is flux of thermal energy, is given by minus k into dT by dx, which is temperature gradient, and this k is the coefficient of thermal conductivity. Consider phonon gas analogous to molecular gas, then basis of kinetic theory of gases, this capital K comes out to be 1 by 3 CV into nu lambda, where C is lattice specific heat, which measure the phonon density, nu is the average phonon velocity, V is the average phonon velocity, lambda is the mean free path of the phonon. Hence, this total thermal flux reduces to minus 1 by 3 C nu CV V lambda dT by dx. So actually total thermal conductivity received contribution from conductivity due to electron, phonon, hence. So K total is K electron plus K phonon. So basically, as we discussed earlier also, so there is contribution coming from two. So one is from lattice, that is phonon, and other will come from electron, which we will study in at later stage in free electron theory. The expression for thermal conductivity due to electron is deduced as k electron equal to pi square n k square over tau over 3mt. Here n is the number of free electron, which will be discussed at later stage, per mole, and tau is the mean free time of electron before collision with positive ion, where it gives the entire thermal energy. It is observed that expression that k electron is almost independent of temperature, as mean free time varies t minus 1 above d by temperature theta d. So the phonon carry most of the heat energy while electrons stay immobile. We studied in detail that lattice specific heat, as given by Debye law, CV is proportional to this T cube for T less than theta D, and CV is equal to 3NK for T greater than theta D. Hence, corresponding thermal conductivity, which is important, that K phonon is equal to 1 by 3 V lambda alpha T cube for T less than theta D, or K phonon 3 V lambda NK for T greater than theta D. So above expression clearly indicate that thermal conductivity of insulator is constant at high temperature, but is proportional to T cube. At low temperature, this variation in K arises due to phonon-phonon interaction, or we call it enharmonicity. So phonon mean free path. Lambda is found to inversely proportional to temperature, as we discussed earlier. So consequently, the expression for thermal conductivity due to phonon becomes K phonon proportional to T minus 1. So thermal conductivity insulator is proportional T minus 1 variation.
So students, let us summarize what we have learned in this module. Scattering of neutron is a probe to study collision in order to obtain information regarding lattice dynamics through phonon energy. Then inelastic scattering and the concept wave vector linked with the absorption or emission of phonon is important to determine phonon dispersion relation. Have an insight of importance of enharmonicity in crystal interactions. Correlate thermal expansion as a direct consequence of enharmonicity. So basically, thermal expansion comes from exact variation of thermal expansion comes from when we take enharmonicity into account, and visualize thermal conductivity in context of enharmonic crystal interaction. Thank you.